share with you tonight. Are you ready?
Well, greetings, family. What a wonderful opportunity. It's Midday Motivation, and I want to share something with you that I believe is profound for where we are right now, and that is this: managing people while walking in purpose. Can I say that again? You're going to have to know how to manage people while walking in purpose. Listen to this. Sometimes we have to learn how to handle people or manage people that celebrate us on selfish expectations. Did you get that? We got to manage people that celebrate us on selfish expectations. Listen at this. Some people only praise you because of what they think you can do for them. Remember Jesus in the triumphant entry? They celebrated him. They were saying, "We love you, Lord." Same crowd says, "Nobody greater than our God." The same crowd says, "You're the greatest." The same people, they said, "I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. Nobody greater." The same crowd, but then they switched out on him and said, "Crucify him." Think about this. They were saying Hosanna one day, and then they flipped on him and said, "Crucify him and give us Barabbas, free Barabbas." What are you saying? Jesus knew how to manage and handle people that flipped out on him. Here is why. He could handle them because he understood that it was a sign that he was walking the righteous life and a life filled with purpose. Jesus understood that people come and people go. But what I want you to understand is we have to be confident in who we are and then confident in our purpose. How could Jesus handle it, Pastor Ren? Let me give you this midday motivation, this kingdom nugget. I need you to get this. It's gonna be on the screen for you. If you become addicted to their compliments, you'll soon become angry with their criticism. Come on, I need you to get this. I know it's midday motivation, but I need you to get this. If you become addicted to their compliments, you'll soon become angry with their criticism. Why? Because the same people that pump you up today will be the same ones that'll pull you down tomorrow. If we're not careful, we've got to manage people the right way. What do you mean? Manage the expectations, because everybody that comes into your life is not there to add value to you. Sometimes people come so they can suck the life out of you. And when you know who you are, and when you know whose you are, you can manage those people. You can manage the different attitudes. But always understand, I'm not going to get so high on my own supply that I forget that everything I have came from God. Everything I'm doing is because God is enabling me to do it. So what are you saying, Pastor Ren? Don't allow the compliments of people to cause you to forget. Those same people will criticize you on the next day. And if you're not careful, their compliments will raise you up, but their criticism will bring you all the way down. The best way to do it is to handle it like Jesus. He had 12 men around him that had 12 different personalities, and he could manage all of them because he knew who he was and he knew whose he was. My question to you is, who are you? And then here's the second part: who do you belong to? Because when you know who you are and when you know who you belong to, you can manage people and the fickleness that life brings without allowing the highs to get too high and the lows to get too low. I love you, and we're praying for you. And until next time, let's keep building the kingdom one person at a time. But remember, don't become addicted to their compliments, because you'll soon become you'll become angry at their criticism. Let's keep building.
You made the lame man walk again. You caused the dead to rise. And that's why we dance in liberty. 'Cause you're doing it all again.